Let's read 1 Peter chapter 4, verse 7. 1 Peter chapter 4, verse 7. Today we won't talk too much. Chapter 4, verse what? But I'll read it in Amplified Bible. Okay. Also, American Standard Version, it says, but the end of all things is at hand. Be ye therefore of sound mind, and be sober unto prayer. Can you see that? It's verse what? 7. Let's pray. Thank you for your word. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Today, let us not waste time. Let's talk about prayer. One day when I was hearing Peter and John go into the temple, the Bible says it was an hour of prayer. You know, Jesus also spoke about it. He said, the house of my Father is of prayer. Prayer is very, very important. So, in our churches today, we are looking to have time of prayer or service of prayer. I think that's where things are difficult in the church, and people are not receiving. Many times when I read in the Bible, I found that prayer is there for divine answers from God. When I read about prayer, it says in Psalm 61, if you read from verse 1, it says, our God attend to our prayer. So you can see that prayer brings God closer. Prayer brings God closer. I was trying to find why we pray and we don't get results. And how far we must pray. And this was a question from the beginning of centuries. Because even the disciples asked Jesus how they must pray or what to pray. So prayer is so important that we need to know what is prayer. As I say, what is prayer? Always, you'll find that prayer is there because there is God. Prayer is the communication between you and God. That's all. Tell anybody, prayer is your communication between you and God. If you read Acts 20, verse 31, it says, God hears our prayers. Something called prayer, it needs God. Normally, it does not need an idol. It needs God. Prayer. God hears our prayers. I have read in Acts 12. Let's go there. In Acts 12.
Chapter 12.
Where the disciples prayed. Acts 12,
chapter 12,
from verse 1, it says, now about that time Herod the king put forth his hands to afflict certain of the church, and he killed James, the brother of John, with a sword. And when he saw that it pleased the Jews, he proceeded to seize Peter also. And those were the days of unleavened bread. And when he had taken him, as you can see, he put him in prison and delivered him to four quaternions of soldiers to guard him, intending after the Passover to bring him forth to the people. Look at verse 5. It says, Peter therefore was kept in prison, but prayer was made earnestly of the church unto God for him.
Amen.
That verse is very, very important. Prayer was made. It means prayer must be made. We need to reach a level where we say, this is what we are praying for. And look at this verse 6. And when Herod was about to bring him forth, the same night Peter was sleeping between two soldiers bound with two chains and guards before the door kept the prison. And behold, an angel of the Lord stood by him, and a light shined in the cell and smote Peter on the side and awoke him, saying, rise up quickly. And his chains fell off from his hands. Can you see that?
Amen.
And the angel said unto him, guard, gird thyself and bind on thy sandals. And he did so. Let's Amen. Leave there. But I want to show you something, that when they gave themselves to prayer, and they say their petition was to set Peter free. When they were carrying on praying, look, God, when God hears that prayer, he sent for the angel. Remember that prayer is the communication between us and God, not with angels. Not with angels. After God hear the prayer, he sent for the angel. God hears our prayer, but he sent for the angel. And the Bible says they continue in prayer, but they set themselves for that petition, and God answers the prayer. The angel came, and the chains went down, and Peter stood up. And look here, if you can see what prayer does there, the time that Herod said was of tomorrow to deal with Peter. But prayer brought salvation of Peter before he faced the trouble. That's what prayer does. Prayer sustains you and brings salvation before danger. Prayer sustains you and bring salvation before danger. So a Christian who prays will never face that danger. Will never face what the Herod wants to do. Whatever you face, God can allow it because it won't destroy you. Remember, Peter was supposed to be destroyed. But when the disciples pray, remember, he was sleeping. And he also had chains. But God sustained him until the angel came to loosen him from those chains. And the Bible says to Peter, he was like he's dreaming. Because that's how God does. God wants to use prayer so that when salvation comes, it will be like you're dreaming. Usually when salvation comes, many of us, because we have planned it, we are not surprised. But this one, it must also surprise you and amaze you. Because if you read, the Bible says, he felt like he was dreaming. It means there was no way he could escape. That's what prayer can do. Prayer is there to bring the impossible results. Write it down. Prayer is there to bring impossible to become possible to us. That's what happened that day. So I love prayer.
So
because that's the way our God will define Himself to us and show His ability, what He can do to the one who prayed,
or
the one who are prayed for. Therefore, it means also you need people to pray for you.
Because
can you see that? The danger on Peter was already there. And his prayer was not mentioned. It's only these people when they are carrying on with prayer in a group. And you know, this prayer of a group brings corporate anointing. And corporate anointing works to make a danger to be prevented by bringing salvation before danger is executed. Tell somebody, my friend, you need prayer and you need people who can pray for you. I'm sure you're hearing that. So Peter was prayed for. And salvation came. Hallelujah.
Amen.
As I say, my friend, are you praying? Is there anybody who's praying for? Say yes. Say, who's that? It's your pastor and your church. If you read Colossians 4, verse 2, Colossians 4, verse 2. It says, continue in prayer and watch in the same with thanksgiving.
Amen.
Continue in prayer and watch in the same with thanksgiving. In other words, God doesn't want us to stop praying. He wants us to pray. And after we have prayed for something, we carry on thanking Him for that thing. God wants a prayer of faith
whereby
after you have prayed for Him, you're watching is when you are thanking Him for what you pray for.
It's not when you say,
now I don't know why it didn't come.
Father,
I don't know why. After you pray, you must carry on saying, thank you, Lord, you have done it. You must continue. That is how you can continue in your prayer. That's how we can bring some solutions. You know, the reason why our prayer is not of faith
is
because after we pray, when we don't see anything, we worry. But to continue of prayer after we pray is when we thank Him of what we pray for. What is it that you're going to say? Thank you, Lord. You heard my prayer. You are God who hears. You are God of wonders. Thank you, Lord, for what I have prayed for. You have done it. I glorify you. I can see my job. I can see that is coming in my life. You can't wake up and say, I'm not seeing anything. Because a Christian prays a prayer of faith, he's the one who continues prayer. And his prayer is embraced with hope. Tell your neighbor, your prayer must be embraced with hope. And he who hopes will continue. Hallelujah.
Amen.
If you remember 1 Thessalonians chapter
5,
if you can read from 17 there, I think it can help us to 18. Because usually we read
17.
Thessalonians chapter 5.
But Thessalonica 5.
Let's go there.
It says 17.
Verse 17. It says what?
It
says, pray without ceasing. 18 says, in everything give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus to you.
Amen.
To you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
In everything, give thanks to God. In everything. I pray, I'm still feeling pain. Thank you, Lord. I know the healing has come. And you know why there is this pain, Lord. Thank you, Lord. If we do that, we won't be robbed of the glory. The reason why we are, there is a delay. And we can't see what God can do. It's because after we have prayed, we don't go to God and say, thank you, Lord. The Bible says, pray without ceasing. You know, one day I told people, I says, pray without ceasing means pray without a reason. Pray without a reason means you have prayed, but you have got no reason to pray, but you carry on praying. You can't see what you have prayed for. So for you to continue to pray is like useless, but you still carry on praying because you know what will come. So that's why I say your prayer must be embraced with hope. Hope makes you to see beyond. Tell them, hope makes me to see beyond. I can see the answer. So I will thank God as I can see beyond. Sometimes your ability of bringing the results can be very difficult in your prayers. But that doesn't mean that God will not hear your prayer. Remember, the moment you kneel down to pray, it's your communication between you and God. So that doesn't mean that God will not hear your prayer when you're not receiving. No, He heard your prayer. But you know, there's the will of God there. Remember the will of God. The will of God is there for the glory of God. The glory of God is there for the people to praise Him. So if you can see anything, God might be gathering the best so that people will praise God. Some blessings are not blessings until God brings it in the right time so that people will praise God. Do you know that sometimes God can spare you for a while? It becomes His way. Are you hearing me?
Amen.
If we just cry to God and say, oh God,
yeah,
give me healing, it happens. I can tell you that the one who brought that disease can still plan them more to kill you. You need to know that God can sustain you so that you understand why there is a pain. So when you endure in that pain and standing on the will of God, God can make you to understand that when pain comes, when you're not expecting, you'll be able to kick it away in the name of Jesus. I don't know if you're hearing me. So any struggle that comes to you, it's not there to kill you. It's there to build you up in prayer so that you'll be able to see the one you're communicating with. I don't know if you're hearing that. Tell some of my friends, I want to pray. Say, I want to pray. Our problem is we are prayerless. And what makes us to prayers, we don't know. And then we are just, oh God, you know. And some of us, we thank God when the food is already in the mouth. Say, I didn't pray. Oh. And when the meat is still here, you
and
can say, for Father,
sorry, Madim.
I want to thank you for food. And before, you can't say before I eat.
And I also want to tell you before I eat.
Because already I eat, you say, as I'm eating. And maybe God say,
Motomo Madim Bare,
who told you to eat? And you begin to say, and, but already there's something of another
way. A clear
prayer, a Christian who doesn't pray is always disobeying God. A Christian who doesn't pray is always disobeying God. Because you communicate, your communication back. Hallelujah.
Amen.
How many of you are praying? Lift up your hands. Say, I want to carry on prayer. I want to enjoy prayer. There is some reasons or some things that makes you to fail to pray. Do you want to know that? Can I tell you? Can I tell you things that makes you to fail? To pray. Are you going to be prayerful after you know the things that makes you to fail? Okay, number one.
Samatom.
Proverbs 15, verse 29. The Bible says, the Lord is far from the wicked. But he hears the prayer of the righteous. God can hear a prayer of a wicked. Do you know what's the meaning of a wicked? A wicked is a person who knows the truth and carry on living a lie. If you know this is a lie, you confess, you carry on lying,
you're
a wicked. A wicked is a person who knows the truth, who always doing wrong. You know to kill is wrong, eh? But
they're
killing. Lying is wrong, but you're lying. Stealing is wrong, but you're stealing. So a wicked cannot be changed by anybody. He carry on. In other words, sin lives in him. That's why the writer of Romans says, he is overpowered by sin.
That
sin rules him. When you are wicked, you are ruled by your sin. So, he who is wicked can pray. You understand now why you can pray?
Eh?
Think about you are just coming from Jolly. And you are coming to pray. Can you pray? You stole something where you are working. Can you pray? When you kneel down there, already you are written off. You got a serious accident. You are a car which is written off. When you kneel down, what are you going to say?
Yes.
You just, oh God, forgive me. Because, you know what you have done. Why do you ask me forgiveness? You know, Peter said, it's very hard to bring a Christian and repent him, because he's like he has crucified Christ
again.
It's like he has crucified Christ again. It's very hard to bring him again. And also, the Bible says,
in
the book of Romans chapter 6,
says,
can we carry on sinning so that the grace of God will be abound? And the Bible says, no. We cannot just take advantage of the grace and we end up sinning knowing. I don't know if you're hearing me. We can't carry on sinning knowingly that, because let me show you the scripture I'm talking about. Open Romans chapter 6. Maybe to help us in our prayers. That's why we are failing to pray. Because, you know, carrying on. Once you open your mouth, the way you insult it. But you are a Christian. Can you just read verse 1? It says, Romans 6 verse 1. It says, what shall we say then? Shall we continue in what? In what? In sin, that the grace may abound. Verse 2 said what? God forbid. We who die to sin, how shall we any longer live therein? This verse says, God forbid. It's impossible for a Christian to sin. Because we have died in sin. So, now, why do you pray when you sin? Can you see that that's how it's difficult to pray? So, the grace is not there. So, the moment you want to kneel down to pray, you can't pray. You don't have the grace.
All
right, let's go to number two. Maybe to help us. Why we fail to pray. In Luke 22, verse 45.
Luke 22:45.
Let's go there. Luke 22.
Luke 22.
Let's go to verse 45.
Real verse 45.
Are you there?
Litotsi.
When he rose up from his prayer, he came unto the disciples and found them sleeping for sorrow there. And he said unto them, why sleep ye? Can you see there? He was shocked. He said, why you people are sleeping?
Why in about to live of age?
And the Bible says, they slept for sorrow. You see the verse there? He came back from prayer. Remember, he said, just be with me only 1 hour.
This,
you know, my worry was, these guys can't even pray 1 hour. They were with Jesus. But 1 hour was impossible to,
1 hour
for them to pray. I know some Christians, they say they work with God, they can't pray. They just say, God, I'm sleeping now, eh? Are you hearing me? God, are you hearing
me?
So bring good dreams here.
Eh?
So I'm sleeping now, eh? So you heard me, eh? They put their blankets. And it's, you know, witches come with food. And open their mouth. So, can you see what happened here?
Yeah.
These guys, they cannot even pray for 1 hour. And the Bible says, the problem was sorrow. Sorrow. They really had their own sorrow. So you can question what is sorrow. Because sorrow makes them to sleep there. They slept because of sorrow. What is sorrow? It's mental suffering. Or distress over afflictions. Or loss. In other words, they had a distress because they have lost something. If you try to reason what you don't have, you can't pray. If now you face trouble, you get to reason to it. Because it's a mental suffering. You are bringing things to your mind. Remember the Bible says, renew your mind by the word of God. It means there are things that weary your mind and make your mind tired. You can't pray when your mind is tired. So automatically you'll be thinking about this problem, thinking about another one, questioning why at work I've got this, in my job, what. You forget the will of God. You forget the Bible says, you must thank God for everything because it's the will of God for you. Yes, there are some things that can bring pain and automatically you can feel depressed. But here, the word that has been mentioned is die stress. Because there's a loss of something. Do you know that you are losing things when you are challenged? Tell me, you are losing things when you are challenged. It's not that you are losing materials. Sometimes when you are out of your comfort, you lose your confidence. So there are many things you can lose in life when you don't have that confidence. So automatically Satan can attack your mind and make your mind to suffer. Sleeping becomes difficult. Prayer becomes difficult. Some people here can't pray because Satan makes them to reason some things, and others sleeps by tablets because already there's a problem with them. We need people who can say, I have time with God to pray. And you pray until prayer brings joy. God works by the peace. Pray until you find peace in you. Therefore, God has done it. Let me tell you, there are three stages of prayer. Number one, when you pray, it's like you are settling your grounds. After you settle your ground, that's why, how do you settle your ground? By praising him. In your prayer, you must praise him. You are settling your ground. You are trying to clear some things. They must go away from you. From you. You are creating. You know, those people who understand their things, they say, you are creating some vibrations. So that there must be no wrong interference which you and the one you are speaking in, you don't want. The second stage of prayer is when you are fighting. When you are fighting, it means now you reason the word and you speak the word in, because you fight a fight of faith. So you can't pray without the word. You pray by the word of God. You fight the fight of faith. You reason the word. You speak the word. But Father, you said in your word, listen, by doing that you are fighting. The last stage is when you get breakthrough, is thanksgiving. Tell someone, my friend, I want to pray and I want to enjoy prayer. When you reach that level, when you reach the level where now, when you are fighting by the word of God, enjoy it. Begin to thank him because God has done it. We need Christians who can enjoy prayer as you enjoy food. I want to enjoy prayer. Ask somebody, say, how many minutes you pray? Because you hear somebody say,
God and our sisters. God and our sisters. God and our sisters. God and my ancestors.
You question, or this person is so fast, he can go underground and go to.
Ota otolo romoto na le spirit says oluya katasi mowa ya koli hodimo.
Kiani kopa nya we.
I'm combining you, Kai.
Kini kopa nya we.
Kai.
That's on the lima touch because why wa
kopa nya. Kalau there you have problems because those that meet together they fight. God and ancestors, when they meet together there is a fight.
So you are creating problems on your life because you bring barimu,
because you call ancestors and God so that they come together. Where in my workplace, you will have some problems.
There's
at
some
your workplace.
Problem you never solve. So there is a problem here. Unless we deal with our mind, we clear the pain of during the day. You must check. Before you pray, when you kneel down, when you say, oh God, I thank you for this day,
right?
Satan will bring what happened in the day. Satan is very wise because he knows it's there in your mind. So whatever that is in your mind will come. When you are busy. Remember when you have got sorrow, like these disciples, they had sorrow, they slept. If you sleep, already you can't fight. You talk something which is not there. Because you begin to say, oh God,
I'm seeing you. I'm even seeing my father-in-law.
Why we are more KFC?
Why are you going to KFC? What is it that you're doing there? Let's go and eat Nando's.
It's what you were doing during the day. Everything will be mixed up. The moment you hear, I'm talking nonsense.
Yeah.
You wake up and say, oh, sorry, God.
I thank you.
When now you're on your strength, because your mental is affected. And you sleep. God, boyfriend,
I don't know where my boyfriend is going to give you money.
There's
somebody who proposed me yesterday.
Now you are reporting yourself.
Don't know what the reporter or him.
The moment you realize already,
you wake up.
Oh, no, sorry. So you realize that you are defeated. We need Christians who read the Bible. Okay, let me show you the scripture that talks about it. Because Without the word of God, we can't pray. That is the third thing. Without the word of God, you can't pray. Look at Proverbs
28.
Also, verse 9. It says, he that turn away his ear from hearing the law, even his prayer shall be abomination.
Amen.
You know, if now you don't have, because here, hearing the law, which is the word of God. Remember the Bible says, meditate the word of God day and night. So he who stop hearing God is he who is sinning already. He who doesn't go by the word of God, automatically that person can pray. Your prayer is coming from the word of God. You must check. The more you read the word of God, is the more you pray. Check your percentage of studying the word and of prayer.
Okay.
Check what you are saying when you pray. If you don't study the word of God.
I remember a long time ago when we were doing all night prayers of praying the whole night. I would see some other people praying the whole night when we are together. It was me who was leading the issue of prayer in our church.
All night prayer,
all night prayer, we will come together to pray. We want to pray for this. There is another group that will amaze me a lot. They can speak one word for a very long time. I thank you. You will see that the word of God is not there. When the word of God is not there,
all the time.
You can speak only one word most of the time. God of nations. You are good.
You know,
if you are holding shambok and you are beating up your child, I'm asking for forgiveness. You can show us that you are still a baby.
Because you don't have the word of God.
Because
you can't grow. And you don't know what to say.
And now people are so many. You are a good God. You are a good God.
You don't always. But you don't
always
even have a
God
verse.
Is good, but you don't even have one verse. God, you are good.
Such people,
but
very soon, you'll be surprised they kneel down now. And they do like this. If you make mistake, you finish prayer.
You will hear somebody waking up. There's nobody who is like you.
And you
will never be able to say, no, we are not yet there. You'll find that there are so many people who are like that.
So in that time where I began to say, Mama,
our
prayers,
those that we are doing with these people, because when we know in a chair, it's like we have been in, somebody has yes into
the
nurse.
There comes one old lady, I don't forget.
That mama
began to say, because she was praying Zulu. She slept. The moment she slept there, she wake up and say, thank you, Lord! No, she wake up when we shout, thank you, Jesus. You are wonderful. Yeah. When she wake up then, she'll be saying, Nyabonga, Nkulukulu wami.
Thank you, God.
Nyabonga,
thank you, God. Thank you, God.
That day she forget but really king kulukulu
fela.
We shouted the moment we shouted. She make people to laugh.
Ngibonga izinja zakho uNkulunkulu wami. Izinja zakho ziyaluma. Because even if you hide
somewhere, because your mind is diluted, you will be caught there. There's no word of God. So listen to this. Train your mind to have the word of God. Otherwise, you will hide. So that people, but one day, you'll come out. People will say, ah, what you are saying is not prayer. Are you hearing me? I want to pray. And I want to continue in prayer. And I want to enjoy prayer. And I want to have peace in prayer. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let's finish by, let me show you some, because those are my experiences. There are too much experience I've experienced in life. Philippians 4 verse 6.
But Philippians 4 6.
This verse is important as I'm finishing now, because we cannot talk many things here, and I believe God is going to help us. Can you read that verse aloud, verse 6? In nothing,
he exerces,
but in everything by prayer. Can you see that verse there? That verse says, a Christian is there also. Not only to talk with God, but also when you want something,
he tells God.
A Christian is also there to get something from the one you communicate with. The Bible says, let everything be known unto
God
by prayer.
Prayer,
you can use it to get something from
God.
You need to know that it's out of prayer that your father must know what you want. Do not be anxious. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Tell your God. If you tell your God by prayer, after you tell your God, you give thanks. Give thanks. Remember the Bible says, the book of Matthew chapter 6, it says, God knows what you want before you ask him. You must know that he knows what you want. But you must know that everything by prayer. Okay, let's look at this last verse.
We're
still going to learn about prayer in future. Matthew 21, verse 22. Prayer is important. Check if there's something in your mind that devil might be putting so that you won't pray. 21:22, he says what? Can you read it aloud in your Bible? That verse is important. You see, I want to jump something when I'm praying there.
He says,
and all things whatsoever you shall ask in prayer, you shall receive. I jumped something there. It says, all things whatsoever you ask in prayer, you shall receive. So if you can check there, our problem is we must believe. Check there. It says, and all things whatsoever you ask in prayer, believing, you shall receive. Can you see that now? The distance between us
distance
and what we need is when we are believing in prayer. You are praying, believing that God can bring it. Simple. You shall receive. It's simple as that. In everything you want in life, When you ask him, you shall receive. When you are believing. So your prayer, it means it can be faked. You can still fake prayer.
It's
when you pray, not believing. There's nothing you can receive. God wants you to receive something. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And if you read that verse also, and it says, whatsoever means everything. Everything means everything. It means a prayer of the one who believes. Listen to this. If you can just have belief, you can receive anything. It's impossible. To a Christian just to lack something. Because we need Christians who believe.
Just to believe.
What's the meaning of belief? There's a difference between believing and faith. Faith says now. You hear me? Faith says what?
Now.
Believe means God's time. The moment you say, I've asked, I believe, you say, I know God will do by his time. So therefore, you won't worry. You know what can make you to worry is faith. Because faith, when you say, I'm receiving healing now, you are still feeling pain. Are you hearing me? You're still feeling pain. So doubt can come.
But
to cancel that faith. But we need Christians who can say, I believe. They carry on even if they are not seeing. Trusting that God has done it.
You will receive.
Are you HIV positive?
Or HIV positive?
Believe.
Dumela.
When you pray, you will receive. Even if doctor can say you are still HIV positive, because you believe, it means that HIV is going.
HIV?
I can give you an example. One time I prayed for someone
who
was very, very sick. And then I say, you see what? You are going to come back with a testimony. And then I believe my God. Though I had faith. I believe that this person is going to come back. And they call.
Bafona.
And say, now the situation is worse. You know what I said? I spoke like Jesus. I
says,
the disease is coming out. That's why it's like this.
That's why we like.
The person was brought here. I say, I could not believe it's you. I even forget it's you. I don't know if you're hearing me. So look what happened to Jesus and Lazarus. The moment he was told, he had faith and believed that this has happened for the glory of God. Though it's not there. But when he reaches there, something will happen. If Jesus might have used faith for the same thing, he would just say, go. Lazarus is healed. When they turn there, they will find that the same hour it has happened. But Jesus kept on believing. I don't know if you're hearing me. It was not the first time Jesus used belief. And he ended up receiving by faith when he reached there. I don't know if you're hearing me. Because belief keep you to the time of God. Tell a neighbor, believe keeps you to the right time of God. If you remember when Jesus was moving, there was a lady that was bleeding for 12 years. And they say, no, the child is dead there. When they turn there, they say, no, don't trouble the master. He didn't say, have faith. He said, keep on believing. Because we are going there. When I reach there, something will happen. We need Christians who pray and believe that the time of God, they can see it. It might be now. And this can happen. And it will happen for them. If you believe, say amen. How many of you believe today is your day? Do you have something to change your situation? You can stand up to pray. Let's stand and pray. Do you want to pray and see something happening? Nothing is impossible before God. Nothing is impossible before God. I want us to clean our minds. Are you hearing me? I want us to clean our minds. And so that we sanctify ourselves in holiness. When we pray, when we believe, something will happen. How many of you believe that by me coming here, something will happen? You believe. Can you just ask God whatever you want in prayer and you shall receive prayer? Prayer. I can't hear you. Prayer. Prayer.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Prayer. I can't hear you. The way you are praying down, down, down. I can't hear you. Prayer. 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 Riba baba 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 basi. Riba baba baba shatara baba baba shi. Rita tata tasi katara baba 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 baba. She tara baba 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 shi katara baba baba shi. Kara baba baba shi tere bebe bebe bebe. She tara baba 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 baba. Prayer. In Jesus' name. Amen. Sit down. Clap hands for yourself. To be honest with you, always I have a great challenge.
Especially,
I'm very much jealous of you.
Jealousy.
Because I want God to do mighty works for you. And sometimes when I look at you, I question, are they really understanding what is coming? I want us, I'm going to do it with these pastors we are having.
With
some people here we are going to choose here to have time of prayer. Because God showed me that He wants to use people in an amazing way.
Then
He prayer sharpens your understanding. It brings the word of God in you.
And when you're like talking,
when you are talking it, it brings light to your eyes to see. Because you read the word of God, you talk it in prayer. From there, your eyes must get light. So we need you people to go and sit down to have time with the word. Not to live a Christian life. No, I attend
charis.
Maybe I'm going there for prophecy. Just want to hear what God says. But here, there's no base on the word of God. I mean, that's what our generation is like now. Just want to hear about my job. I want to hear about my what work. Yes, we are here for that also. But let's have time also with the word of God. Not long here, I was telling Mama, I said, you know, to be a pastor is a very great challenge. You can end up studying the word of God for other people. It becomes profession. That's what the Bible says, will be judged. Because you need time with God also. And you also need time for other people. So I was telling you, I say, this is what our generation, they don't know. Just us preaching that sometimes we don't even have time for ourselves. You have to create it for yourself
now.
Otherwise, automatically you will just open the Bible, you find
yourself
not hearing what God is saying. And you find everybody is not moving. The church is deteriorating. It end up being like a
spasation.
I'm believing God for you people. That as long as you are here, nothing is impossible to God. Nothing is impossible. If we can pray, prayer can bring answers. Not only answers, but as long as we are grounded in the word of God. And also, we must create...